go long, go short, buy the dip. All terms that you guys have probably heard if you've been following active traders before. Traders have all kinds of lingo that are used on a daily basis, even here on our live program. And sometimes you've heard of them, sometimes you haven't. Today, we want to go over a few of our favorite trading terms for everyone's deeper understanding, so when they get thrown around, you understand what they mean and why they might be important. I've named a few here, guys, and just to tee it off, I know we've been sitting on floors for a very long time, and there's things that we will say without thinking twice about them, and really, you know, it's important to try to have people understand what these terms mean so that they're not just sort of being misused or misinterpreted on a daily basis. It's always important to get the terminology down when you make something your profession.
Correct. Yeah. So here's your chance. So you're sitting around the table. You know, it's Christmas. Everyone's talking about the stock market. At least that's what happens at my house. And people want to say, okay, let's talk about some terminology here, because I'm hearing everybody say right now that the market is in bull or bear territory. And right now, you know, those are some common terms that I often hear misused, believe it or not. And I think it's because we're not quite sure on the definition. I don't have anything written down here for the definition because it's pretty simple. And it's just a bear. First of all, bull market, let's start with bear. Bear market is 20% off of recent highs. And we're talking about the market. So it's generally spoken when you're dealing with the S&P 500, not the NASDAQ. But if you say the NASDAQ's in bear market, then you're right. We only have a few instances from 2000 where there's been a bear market. There was one over here in 2000 where, you know, we had the dot-com bubble, things like that started to burst. So we go from, you know, down to down. This is 1024. These are the markers of the S&P. So all the way about, you know, 1500 or so down here to 8 and change, right? That's going to be 20%, followed by a bull market. Then you have the bear market in 2008, where we dropped, I think it was 30-something percent all the way to the downside, or even more than that, sorry, 1,500 down to 666, the very famous bottom there. So we get chopped all the way down. That is a bear market. So we even put the little symbols up here, guys. And again, credit to realinvestmentadvice.com giving us this. And then the bull market is a rally. So what the bull market means is actually a sustained rally of ever increasing prices. So that could be, there could be a bull market in the commodities. There could be a bear market in a Forex, Turkish lira, bear market. So bear market is 20% down with negative sentiment. So people are generally negative on the market, but you need to hit that 20% marker. A bullish market has nothing to do with percentages or anything like that. It's just continuously month over month increasing prices. So some would say now that we've been in one of the longest bull markets where you don't get even a pullback in here of more than 10%. So a bull market straight to the upside. A bear market has the more exact definition, guys, of 20% from its most recent high. So that's a bear market, and a bull market is just rolling forward, all ships ahead.
Yeah, and that's the bull and bear market scenario. Now I'm gonna dig a little bit deeper into when you have something like this. I'm gonna focus in on the level two here, top left on my screen. The level two prices, level one prices, you might hear that often. What those refer to, the level one price is the best bid and the best offer, or the NBBO, National Best Bid and Offer, right? Those are the top level prices. That's where the buyers are sitting. That's where the sellers are sitting. Buyer, in this case, on Bank of America, buyers are sitting at 44.23. Offers are at 44.24. That, just ignore the rest of the bottom. Just where you see where the green is flashing, that's the best bid, and right beside it is the best offer. That's the level one price. Now, if you dig deeper, the level two price now goes into how much volume is sitting and everything below that. So including market depth and all price levels below the best bid. So 44.22, 44.21, the lower you get, the more there is. I'll dig this deeper. Here you go. These are all the level two prices with their corresponding sizes. So when we talk about, oh, what's the level one price? What's the current trading price? Where's the best bid? Where's the best offer? And then when you look at level two prices, it's everything deeper than that, looking at volume, looking at sizes, and the different ECNs that we're looking at. Now, for us, we have access to a ton of ECNs, right? You can see everything here. You see EdgeX, NSB, MEMX, BATS, PhilEx. We have IEX in there as well, but BATY, BYX. They're all part of the level two size. So anytime you go to get a fill, let's just say you hit the market order, your broker, based on the SEC rules, has to fill at the best offer or the best bid. So they have to go to the level one price, and then if they run through enough volume, they move on to the next offer. So if this case, in this case, you say you want to buy 10,000 shares. Now, there's not 10,000 on the offer here on Bank of America, but if you hit a market order, they will take everything they possibly can at 26 before moving on. That's why when you send an aggressive limit order, let's say I send an order for 44.30, they have to go in sequence on what's available first. 27 is available first. Then they'll move to 28. Then they'll fill whatever hasn't been filled at 29. They're not going to just skip the line and give you 44.30. That's not how the rules are set up for fills. So in terms of level one prices, level two prices, that's where you're looking at the best bid, best offer. That's your level one. And then anything past that, including volume and depth, is going to be level two.
Exactly. And we could go all day when it comes to trading terms here. Obviously, we can turn this into a regular thing. I'll give you one last one because I say it all the time very quickly, and it's capitulation. Really, it's just the act of surrendering or ceasing to resist an opponent or demand. Look, the dictionary definition doesn't matter. In a trading sense, capitulation simply means when the bid or the ask gives up. You saw that level two there. If you have downward movement in a stock or an upward move, and there's buying and selling on the way up, there's buying and selling on the way down. When that bid ceases to exist or grinds to nothing, or the offer in the case of a short squeeze, that's when there's a capitulation on one side and you get exacerbated moves. That's where you see those halt trades. That's where you see circuit breakers start to come in. So capitulation is going to be my addition there. Some fantastic terms, bulls, bears. Also talking about the level two, which is your gateway to the markets in addition to charts and capitulation. There's your trading terminology here for today, and hopefully use them to your advantage.